I try not to, never be like who I am. Yeah. Nobody has ever seen Rajkummar on screen.
I have been told that only you can only be a successful actor if you are very, very, very thin.
You can't be a lead actor because eyebrows are too bushy.
Like for example, in as Pritam Vidrohi, when I say hello, that's how my brother-in-law speak. If I'm confused, I'll do this. Oh shit, I'm confused.
Rajkummar Bhumi, Ayushmann, first of all, congratulations on your stellar year.
Thank you.
You've all done such good work and it's been such a joy to see you on screen.
Thank you.
So I want to start by just revisiting the characters you have played in the last three movies. Bhumi for you, Sandhya Verma, school teacher in from Haridwar in Dam Laga Ki Haisha. Jaya Joshi, a college graduate who lives on the outskirts of Mathura in Toilet Ek Prem Katha. Sugandha from Delhi in Shubh Mangal Saavdhan. Those are yours. Ayushmann, you've been Bubla. I love that name. An author of erotic horror novels and banker from Kolkata in Meri Pyari Bindu. Chirag Dubey, the owner of a printing press. Once again, an author in Bareilly Ki Barfi. And Mudit Sharma from Gurgaon, who has a marketing job in Shubh Mangal Saavdhan. Rajkummar, you've been Gattu from Lucknow in Behen Hogi Teri. I don't think he had a job, right?
No.
He didn't.
He did not mention that he had a job.
He was dreaming of becoming like...
Uski kuch umeede thi, but kuch nahi hua. Then, my favorite name, Pritam Vidrohi. Love that name. Sari salesman in Bareilly. And of course, Newton, Nutan Kumar, an election officer in Newton. Now, all these characters were the lead in the films that they were in. And most of these films were really successful. You have just delivered a hat trick. So, really. I mean, that is a rare thing. You three have become the voice and the face of the ordinary person in mainstream Hindi cinema. Is this a boon or is this a burden?
I think it's a boon, definitely, yeah. Because, you know, I've said this time and again that I think we sort of represent 70% of what India is. You know, 70% of India lives in smaller towns, smaller areas. We are not all Bombay, Delhi bred people. And if we get a chance to represent them, I think the number of characters we'll get to do automatically increase.
I think also those are the kinds of films even audience want to see now, mostly.
Yeah. I think the numbers are amazing.
Yeah, I just feel very blessed that we are representing that cinema. We are today working in the industry where it is definitely changing. The shift has definitely has happened. So I think that's the reason probably, you know, audience connect to us because they think that, you know, you guys are not selling us dreams. You guys are showing us reality. We could connect to your characters. We could connect to the life that you're portraying.
But how hard is it to be that real middle class, ordinary person from Mathura, from Lucknow, from in a film industry that is really about aspirational fantasies, or at least traditionally has been in many ways, you know?
Nothing is easy.
Yeah. I mean, is it hard to be who you are?
I try never be like who I am. Yeah. Nobody has ever seen Rajkummar on screen.
Really?
Yeah. I always try and portray my character, live my character's life. But it is definitely difficult if you take it seriously. You can always go on set, you know, do your little makeup, wear nice clothes and say your lines and come back and do your promotions and just get the F out of there. But as an actor, I feel every character is difficult, every character is challenging. It's up to you how much you want to work hard towards that character.
The question is, what is aspirational these days? I think the definition of aspirational has changed a lot. I think for me, aspirational is presenting something completely different and novel to people. That is aspirational. And giving them something which is close to reality. A lot of people who have migrated from smaller cities to bigger cities, urbanization is happening, and those people are primarily youth. And they are the ones who throng the multiplexes and they watch cinema which is close to their heartland. And I think that's aspirational. I think the aspirational word has changed, the meaning has changed.
I agree. Because, you know, today you have everything on your phone. Like, yeah. I don't need to see the snow-capped mountains of Switzerland because I can do it easily with a lot more things involved in it, you know. So, I think today people want to see real-life stories. I think suddenly there's been this wave where people find a lot of pride in their country. They want to be associated with stories that can sort of change a little bit, and I'm not saying that because I've only done films that are, like, you know, socially relevant. No, I truly feel today cinema is changing. The definition of commercial cinema has completely changed.
Of course. Ayushmann, I don't know if you remember, but when I had talked to you and Pariniti, just before Meri Pyari Bindu, she had talked about filmy acting. And she had said that she kept telling you through the film, just ramp it up, ramp it up. Yeah. So what is filmy acting?
I don't know.
I act in a film, so that's a film.
But you know, because I was casting before I became an actor, I've seen that bit because people have, we've watched films through our, we've watched films that's growing up. So we're just used to hamming.
I think, yeah.
You know, I've really seen actors ham, and at times it's so difficult because you just don't know how to react. How do you reach that wavelength and give a reaction? Imagine us doing scenes where we're like hamming.
I think it's just an old term that people are using. Like early in film, there were a couple of actors who were really, you know, over the top and loud. And from even our theatre, actually, films came from Parsi theatre, which was really loud. Mm-hmm. So I think filmy acting is probably in real. If I just look at you, if I have to feel angry, I'll probably feeling internally in real. But filmy is when you have to show that you're angry.
Eyebrows.
And you're, your nostrils will go up.
Nostrils flaring.
Everything lit up.
That's the best way people emote anger. Yeah.
If I'm confused, I'll do this. Oh shit, I'm confused. So that just in case somebody doesn't get it, I am confused,
I think it depends on the tonality of the script as well and what directors want from you. I think Pariniti meant that, you know, just underline certain nuances because I'm the one who's very subtle as an actor. So I don't really, I'm not a loud actor. So that comes from my personality. Of course, you add a little bit of yourself in your character that you play. So I think with me, it's subtlety and probably realism. I can't go over the top, even if I want to.
This adding something of yourself to your character. So both of you in two separate interviews said that you have to be real in life to be real on screen. So first of all, Bhumi, do you agree with this? And then you agree with this? So then how are the three of you going to keep it real as you get more successful and the paychecks and the entourages and the cars get bigger and bigger?
I think it's the people around you, you know, like even when I go home now, I get shouted at. If I leave the geyser on, my mom makes sure that I take a U-turn and switch it off. It's like, you know, it's like these things that keep you really grounded. I think luckily because I'm from Bombay, I already have a setup. I already have a life. So this is purely professional for me. And when I go back, nobody cares about my acting or whatever I achieve. They are proud of me, but it's not really affected their behavior towards me in any way. And I think that's the only way that can keep us grounded. Hopefully we'll be
absolutely.
Yeah, you need to. Yeah.
No, go ahead, I was just adding to her thing that it depends the kind of people you're surrounded with. Like I'm surrounded with very real people who work in films, but who are very real. We don't keep yes men around us.
Yeah.
Who are just there to tell you how great you are. Yes. You keep people who will tell you, know what, that was really horrible, and you have to believe it. Yeah. You can't take it personally. And then I love doing my own thing. I feel very worried when people say, don't step out of the car. Let me open the door. I said, no, I want to do my own thing. I want to take my own boarding pass from the counter. They're like, you can't take your boarding pass from your counter. That's not what an actor does. I said, I want to talk to that guy on the behind the counter. Exactly. I want to know his life. Yeah. I want to talk to the guy in Uber. I want to live my real life. I don't, just because I'm an actor, I chose to be an actor. Nobody, you know, forced me to be an actor. I chose it because I fell in love with the craft. And that's about it.
I think taking the cue from there, I think you have to be really close to the real life to be an
actor. But kaise karoge when you're surrounding not even the surrounding, but when the walls get higher, right, between you and what is real, how do you stay real?
I think you need to surround yourself with people who are critical.
And do you need to put yourself in situations that normally you wouldn't experience? Do you have to do that?
I love going out at a tapri outside Yashraj studios and have chai with the managers and everybody. They take a smoke break, I take a chai break. I sit there, talk to the person who's serving tea and ask about his life. And as he said, you need to do that. You have to be real. That's also our zone. We are thriving because of realism.
So is everything research then?
No, actually, I don't know. No. You know, this is a very strange question. At times,
deliberately, you don't do that. It's the person you are. It's not by design. Right. Because you are real, you are interacting with real people because you enjoy doing that.
Right. That's you to begin with.
This is an agenda. I need to talk to that person because I need to incorporate his style in my acting. No, nothing like that.
I think I've seen him shoot, like even when I shoot, you know, there's no hierarchy. There is no, this is your job, you can't cross a line. No, like, you know, we are one big happy family. You break bread together, you exchange life problems, you learn so much from people like Seema Pava. She's my guru, like I love her a lot. She trained me for Damla Gaake Haisha, and for 3 months we were only talking. That's how she trained me, because she took me into her life and I realized, you know, what problems women faced then and how it was for a woman then. And I mean, there's so much to learn just from life experiences. And I think that's so important.
And then there are times, you know, while interacting, you might get some of the character trait that will be very interesting.
Sure.
Like, for example, in as Pritam Vidrohi, when I say hello, that's how my brother-in-law speak. Whenever
really?
I call him, he's like, hello. So I thought it's so interesting. I always wanted to use it somewhere. So I thought, why not in Bareilly Ki Barfi?
Was he happy when he saw it?
Of course, yeah, I'm sure. Yeah.
You know, Rajkummar, one of the funniest things I read about you was the reasons why you were rejected at auditions. You said somebody said to you that your eyebrows...
Yeah, somebody said your eyebrows. I thought I'm really proud of my eyebrows. People say, wow, your eyebrows are like...
That's what
see, imagine,
your eyebrows are bushy.
I think that's a lucky thing, probably.
You can't be a lead actor because your eyebrows are too bushy.
Probably that's a lucky thing. People should, you know, shave
these.
All your eyebrows are bushy.
That's my Instagram profile bio. Eyebrows are bushy.
Really?
I've not written actor, singer, nothing. Eyebrows are bushy.
So you've actually heard this?
Yes.
So this is a thing then?
People... Random. Yeah, excuse me.
Bhumi, what's the most bizarre thing you've heard?
Actually, I was always conducting auditions, so
I hope I'm not.
Did you ever say your eyebrows are bushy to anyone?
Not yet. I hope I didn't. Watch on Twitter tomorrow. Yeah. You did. Yeah. Tell us. No, but you know, I think in my first film itself, I sort of broke every sort of boundary, so people didn't really, they couldn't really pinpoint on anything what's wrong with her. You know, I just went naked in front of them. This is how it is. So I've sort of escaped all those comments.
What's another really great line that either one of you has been given? You know, why can't you do it?
I have been told that you can only be a successful actor if you are very, very, very thin. I have been told this. And I've been told this again and
but
again.
But the teen varies. Very, very,
very, very thin. Like, you have to be really thin. And I don't get it. And I think it's my personal agenda to change that.
And you're changing it.
You did already.
Yeah. Because I strongly feel that you should sort of evolve, or you should change your body and your character as per the film requires. I mean, why is it that you only have to do a certain kind? If you're 25 years old, you can't play a mother. Typecast ho jaoge. I get really upset.
I was part of this reality show and one of the producers, I just confessed, so I want to be an actor. And it was like, ek aur ghar barbaad. Tu kyun actor banna chahta hai? Kyun tu actor wali vibe nahi deta hai? Main kaha kaisi vibe doon main yaar? Matlab what kind of vibe do you want from me?
Yeah.
Something Rajpal Yadav also, like I was in one of his early interviews, like main jata tha logon se milne. Yaar tu actor hai par lagta to nahi hai. Like kahan se lagun abhi? Lagun kaise ki main actor hu? Main hu actor.
Thoda swagger hona chahiye.
No, people have the most bizarre things. Somebody actually told me that your lips are too big. I said, since when is that a problem? Aren't people like paying lakhs of money to get that done? Yeah, they can say the most bizarre things, but I think you should just be aware of what you are and not care.
And just stay
like,
with it.
Yeah, and I think the boys especially are like a very good example of that. I'll talk about myself also a little.
Achha, I had once asked Nawazuddin Siddiqui, you know, when you see people who are obviously less talented than you, I mean, he's a great actor, right? And he's had a monstrous struggle.
Everybody is, I think, less talented than Nawaz.
let's just put that out there.
Yeah.
Put it out there. Yeah. So I said to him, you know, itni struggle ki hai. And through this struggle, you watched people who are less talented get many more opportunities, get a lot more money. So I said, kabhi gussa aata hai. So, you know, he paused and he said, pehle bahut gussa aata hai. He said, ab itna nahi hai. So, aap logon ko kabhi gussa aata hai?
Gussa to kabhi nahi aata. I think that's the rule of the life also at the same time. You see, a lot of people who are probably better than you, they are struggling, who are lesser talented, doing better. It's a random world. It's like musical chairs. Like when the music stops, the chair should be there for you.
No, I sometimes take it very personally. I'm a cinema lover. I'm a cinema student. Mm. So I take it very personally when somebody not less, like zero talented, is not comparing him or her with me for sure. just for cinema, Indian cinema's sake, when a really shit film or shit actor, actress...
I think shit film make, more.
Yeah. Shit making film. Money.
I think it hurts.
I feel, you know...
Also look shit.
Yeah. But, you know, I also believe...
You get angry.
No, I get very irritated.
What do you do?
I get very irritated. I just take it, like, discuss with my friends and then forget about it.
I know what he means. Like, when I see a bad film, I get frustrated. And then when I see a bad film
personally.
Being appreciated, I'm like, come on. Really? Like, why? Like, I mean, films, I mean, it's a reflection of our society, you know. You learn, and actors and stars, you know, people are so influenced by them. You have to be responsible. And, you know, in today's time, like, see what's happening around us. The world is literally crumbling, right? It takes a lot to have a happy moment. It takes a lot to enjoy your success with what's happening around you. So you have to be responsible. That pisses me off. Like, I'm okay with the average... talent, you know, whatever, doing well. That's okay, his destiny. Yeah. But then you're firstly, whatever, an average actor doing a pathetic film and then being appreciated for that is wrong. You should not do that film.
I think I like everything. Seriously, I am like that cinema lover. Hi, yaar, theek hai. Like that. I'm self-critical for sure, but I think, but when I watch anything, I'm like, theek hai. I'll probably walk out of it, but I will not. Yeah.
I'll walk out of it. But I'll watch everything.
I'll watch everything.
Of course, once you're in, you can't, unless it's a, like you're paying money, which I will not. In a screening, you can't walk out. Yeah.
No, you can't. I think it's wrong.
You have to tweet also.
Congratulations.
These days I say congratulations, good luck. Yeah.
Mine is also all the best. Yeah, well performed.
If I don't like something, I can't
generic.
Say
you can't praise it.
It's very generic.
That's it. Okay, yaar. It's okay.
Come on.
Not when it comes to art. Yeah. No. Yeah, I really feel there is a social responsibility of me as an actor towards society, towards my people, towards my cinema, and I take it very seriously.
Yeah. I'll do those kind of films.
But
I will. I'll support that person.
See,
it's okay. Go for it, guys.
Being supportive is great. Yeah. This is not about an individual. This is about the project. There are 200 minds working on that film. Why? And when you have an opportunity, you have everything on a platter, right? Why are you going to go for the worst option? I don't understand this thinking. But I think now I should keep quiet.
See, I've done a couple of shit films in my life. And I tell everyone that those are shit films. And I was the most horrible thing in those films. I tell this on people. No, I won't. And people know, of course. I don't have to say. And then you have to accept something is bad. Something is bad. You just can't say because I worked hard on this film and it's my baby. I'm proud of it. No, I'm not proud of it. Those were shit films.
No, and filmmaking, we all accept that there's a lot of effort that goes
into
it. There's a lot of hard work. That's why I do feel bad shitting on a film. But then the only reason we do it is so that more of these films aren't made. Like, you cannot support this crap.
I agree.
Craft for you is art for somebody else.
Bhumi.
Bhumi wants to shake your hand.
Thanks. Come on.
More power to good cinema.
It's all right.
So tell me, how much do you think this success for you and for the type of characters you play, how much does it have to do with the fact that the Hindi film industry, at least when it comes to directors, is far more egalitarian now?
Yeah.
You know, you can have directors coming in from anywhere. Yeah. You know, Anand Rai or Anurag Kashyap or Shujit Sarkar, and making movies and telling stories that they know.
True.
Do you think it is also a factor of sort of the time and the talent coming together at the right place?
100%.
Definitely.
I think, like, I'm definitely only surviving because of that. You know, Adam Laga Ke Haisha would never be made 10 years ago. Thank God for...
We are fortunate that we are born in this era.
Yeah.
10 years down, 10 years back or 15 years back, if probably we went out to become actors on our own, it would have been difficult. I think this sudden surge in talent, not just in acting, but also in direction...
Yeah.
Producers,
story, the kind of stories,
script writers, everything. I think this is the golden era of
writing.
Indian cinema.
Like, there are some, there's some brilliant, like, it's Newton.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, come on.
Thank you. That's something, you know, Manoj sir told me, and I took it, of course, in a very, like, I really love him and respect him. He said, you know, I'm very jealous of you, man. You bloody came in this era. You had to come when we were struggling, looking for work. There were not many films being made.
Absolutely.
And they were only doing, like, one or two films a year, and that too, like, probably playing a guy's friend or a villain, typical villain. It's like, this is such an amazing era for actors.
These films did not make money that time.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So there weren't really a lot of people. Now I think the biggest applause should be for our audience.
Yeah.
Because, you know, at least they're going and watching a Newton or a Shubh Mangal or a Dam Laga Ke Harsha. You know, they're going and watching these films. Like, thank God, because these films really deserve to make money so that you can make more brilliant content. You know, it's a cycle.
It is a cycle.
Yeah.
And finally, the bottom line is really the bottom line. Yeah. You could make great cinema, and if it doesn't make money.
Exactly.
Yeah. You know?
Yeah,
it has
nobody
to.
Nobody can push it after
you can't push
further
it.
After point. Yeah. And thanks to, I think I'm really thankful to Torrent and Netflix and Amazon.
Yes.
And audiences have definitely evolved.
Exactly. Yeah.
They have come out of the well and started watching the outside world. Oh, wow, they are making such amazing things. Yeah. I was
only
watching
this.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like,
I want
the
my
quality.
Most of
the
time. My quality. Most of the time.
Yeah. I had to say that.
Yeah.
I had to say that.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Let's not go there.
But tell me, now that you are, of course, the go-to actors for this specific, for these kind of characters, how do you not get stereotyped? You know, how do you not do the same thing?
By doing omerta and bose.
I don't have
people.
Such an answer.
By doing chambal.
By doing chambal, yeah.
So can you talk about what you're doing? Or not yet?
No, I can, no, not. I can't.
But it's
really
completely
talk
different.
About it. It's completely different. But I think, see, every character is unique. It's on you as an actor how you sort of define every character of yours.
But you're also now going dark.
Yeah.
Is that by design,
Ayushmann?
It's both. In fact, I've always wanted to go dark, but I was waiting for a certain Shriram Raghavan to just... because that was part of my bucket list, that if I have to do a dark film or a thriller, it has to be with Shriram Raghavan or Anurag Kashyap, or, you know, who knows that space and genre. So I'm glad, I'm fortunate that I'm doing this.
Is it hard?
It's fun.
Rajkummar, you said in an interview that the only difference between me and a star is that the star will get more money to produce a film. I have the vanity, I have a luxury car,
everything
is the same. Do you guys also feel this way?
I guess only the budgeting is different.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Budget of the film, that's about it. I think content could be made in 100 rupees also. Like, if you are, it doesn't matter. So I guess if you are convinced with your product, your kind of film, just go for it. And in your head, you're a star of your own right.
Yeah,
that's
exactly.
It.
Yeah.
That's true. That is true. You can't, it's how you see what your perspective is.
Yeah.
But even though the three of you do sort of very different sort of content, you know, when you're on screen, off screen, you are part of that same ecosystem. So you're part of the whole, the sort of, you know, the brand chase that every actor wants. You know, now having brands is so critical. The whole sort of the paparazzi, the airport looks. You know, what is all that like for you? Because you're not making a certain kind of movie.
I'm not chasing brands, I swear.
You're not.
No, I'm not chasing anything. I'm very happy doing one film at a time and giving my 200% to it. That's the only thing I'm chasing in life. Yeah, and I mean it.
For you?
Half of what he said, because, you know, when I was growing up, when I wanted to be an actor, I wanted it all. I wanted the money, the fame, the interviews, walking the red carpet, doing your airport looks. I wanted it all along with substance work. So that's what I'm chasing. I want a balance of both. So I think it's important.
I think you need to concentrate on the real core job to begin with. I think rest is a byproduct. Your, the fame, the money, your looks, brands will come and go. But I think your work, your craft will stay with you. I think that's the most important thing.
See, once you die, people will know you for your films.
Absolutely.
He's done that commercial launch. People will know you for your good work. Yeah. And they will either abuse you or they will either praise you. We will talk about Dilip Saab even after 200 years. Because the kind of quality work is done. And not about so many other stars who probably have done very mediocre or bad work.
I have to tell you the legendary story about Dilip Saab. When somebody offered him a commercial later on in his career, he said, "Hum ishtiharon ke liye nahi bane."
Kya baat?
Wow.
Nahi, aajkal to Twitter timeline bhi ishtihar ban gayi hai sab.
Yeah.
Okay, header change ho jata hai.
You get paid to tweet.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Mommy, is it harder for women? Because the pressure is so much more. I mean, in that same conversation, I remember Pariniti talking about how much this photo thing has just, you know, you have to look a certain way all the time.
No, you have to,
not
but
only
I
girls,
think.
By the way,
even with boys. Yeah. See, the thing is, I enjoy it. Huh. You know, so I can't really, I have been dressing up I've been playing dress up since I was a child. So I enjoy the clothes, the makeup and all of that. But I think I think people scrutinize you more. But you know, if you're a confident person, really nothing matters. I've seen some atrocious pictures of mine and I'm like, it's okay. Yeah, tomorrow there'll be a better picture. People will get over it. Yeah. You know, people are so fickle minded. But I think by doing these events and brands, etc., I mean, you have to keep your life going. You need to make money. I'm being really honest. I think doing that also gives you an opportunity to do the kind of work you want to do, because you'll never succumb to the pressure of doing a project because it'll pay better, blah, blah, whatever. Because it's okay, I'm making my money through other things. This is pure connection to my art that I love.
So tell me, your stories are very inspiring for people who want to follow your path and to be actors without sort of subscribing to the very kind of age-old notion of what makes a Hindi film hero or what makes a Hindi film heroine. What is the one thing you think that has held you in really good stead as you've, you know, traversed this very unformulaic path?
Don't make your eyebrows. It's fine as
Yeah, the eyebrows are going to work out.
Don't
just
work
fine.
Fine, absolutely fine.
Don't go for silicones, yeah. It's okay. Real ones are better. It's a turn off. Yeah.
You know, I
not just the eyebrows, anything, any body part. Just
it's time that people actually concentrate on the acting bit of it, which sort of was out of the window. Just first remember, you're an actor.
Yeah.
Everything else will work out. Like, you know, you just need to act. Don't care about how you're looking, pimple dikh raha hai. No, don't care. As far as it works for the character, it's okay.
Yeah, yeah, a lot of juniors in my college like Bombay mein aa gaye hain ki kya kar rahe ho, actor banna hai, kya kar rahe ho, roz gym jata.
Yeah.
Matlab gym jaane se kya hoga? To matlab theater kar le ya kuch workshop pe ja, gym ja kar tu actor kaise banoge?
Us double se aap baat kar rahe ho ek character bana ke ki tu aaj bhi yahi padha hai. Aaj bhi yahi padha hai tu.
You know, it's so sad, like the current generation, because I was casting, right? Half of them don't even know Hindi.
Yeah,
true. You know, and it is so sad. It is just atrocious. My heart. I mean, it's so important for an actor to read, write, speak the language, because we are doing Hindi
and
films.
Keep their hands straight and not like high.
Yeah, in the pocket.
There's something that Danny Boyle, I read one of his interviews when he came to look for Dev Patel's character in Slumdog. He said, I met some 2,000, you know, Indian boys, and out of 2,000, 1,500 were like this.
Yeah, it's atrocious. So I have to ask. So many actors on social media are constantly posting pictures of themselves in the gym, and I'm like, but acting class ki photo lagao na, because that is what will give us some insight into how you guys do what you do.
Yeah.
But it's all picking up.
But you know, that's also a lot of hard work. Like I built some muscles for America. It's a lot of hard work to make those six packs. Trust me, it's not easy.
So I think,
So full respect to that as well.
So I'm just dismissing it. It is.
It's a lot of hard work.
I don't mind these pictures, but I also wait for the day when we also start putting, like, you know, like how Leo's first look came from The Revenant, or like all these other films, or Daniel's first look as Lincoln, and like, wow!
But they do, right? That also happens.
Changing your hairstyle is not a different look from this film. No. You have just changed your hairstyle. Yeah. That's it.
But change is coming and it is good.
Absolutely.
Change is coming.
Yeah. And
it's a very welcome change.
I think jab bahut sari bakery ki dukaan bhi hai, mithai ki dukaan hoti hai na, bahut achhi lagti hai.
Bilkul.
But you know, I really hope it's not again like one of those phase.
Because
it happens. Beech mein Switzerland bahut famous hua tha, to sab Switzerland ja rahe
the. No, but I think it's changing because you have your so-called commercial actors doing sensible films now. So I think now people have realized that you cannot chapo anything. Chalo, once in a blue moon, maybe a film will also niklo. Yeah. But I think this is like quite a
really
permanent change.
The phase is not about the small town, it's about good cinema.
I think so.
That's it.
On that happy note, thank you so much.
Thank you. Hey guys, if you like this video,
please subscribe
to Film Companion.